carding mills were scattered across the New England landscape. Most mills, including carding mills, were owned by fairly prosperous farmers. They're not buying raw materials, rather they're serving the neighborhood. In this case, neighbors are bringing in wool that's been already sheared, washed, scoured, picked, and the machine here, a series of brushes, just untangles the wool to get it ready for spinning into yarn. Most people are shearing their sheep in late spring, like the end of May or so, when the weather's warmed up and the sheep really don't want their wool, much less need it anymore. So like almost everything else in an agricultural season, carding mills have their peaks and valleys. The busiest time is late spring, and then they're paying to have that very tedious process of untangling wool, sending it through a series of round wire brushes, basically, to untangle the wool and to form it into long, thin rolls for spinning into yarn. Mostly what they're doing with it is spinning it into yarn and then using the yarn to knit stockings, mittens, caps, comforts, which in the 21st century we'd call scarves, things like that. This mill, like most other mills in southern New England, well, all of New England, are powered by water. Before and after carding mills were no longer profitable, people had to card the wool or untangle the wool by hand using what are called hand cards, little bits of iron wire set in traditionally leather on a board, and then the cards, kind of like a dog brush, untangle the wool as you pull it from one brush to another, and then you can doff it and rearrange it, and continue carding until you've got all the fibers aligned in the same direction so that when you put them on your spinning wheel, you have a nice, even, and regular alignment of the fibers to form a nice woolen yarn. But the machine can card 50, 60 times as much wool in the same amount of time somebody could card it by hand. So what would take 2 or 3 days for somebody just steadily doing this by hand, namely card out the wool from one sheep, the machine can do that in less than an hour. The biggest expense in setting up a small custom mill like this, or a grist mill or a sawmill, isn't so much the building or even the machines, but the biggest expense is building a dam or digging canals or both to manage your water power, to force the river to fall in sufficient distance, what's called head, sufficient quantity, what's called flow, in order to provide the energy you need.